Now we are discussing about magnification in a lens. First I am taking magnification in the case of convex lens. Again I am going to generalize the equation. So magnification in a lens. So first I am taking magnification in the case of convex lens. After we are going to generalize the equation for any lens. Now here O dash is the object, O dash is the tip of the object, from the two beam of light coming ray. Rule 1, one beam of light must come parallel to the principal axis, after refraction it goes from the focal point, another beam of light going from the optic center. These two beam of light where it is sitting, there only we are getting image. Okay, now I am assuming if this is angle theta, automatically this also becomes theta. Now, what is the O dash? Height of the object. Height of the object. O dash is the height of the object and I dash is the height of the image. I dash is the height of the image. Now, what is the PO? Object distance. So, PO is the U. What is the U? Object distance. Similarly, PI is the V. What is the V? Image distance. PI is the V. What is the V? Image distance. PO is the object distance and PI is the image distance. Okay, now I am taking triangle OO dash B. Now I am taking triangle OO dash B. In this I am taking tan theta. Okay, now tell what is the tan theta? OO dash by PO. OO dash by PO. This is my first equation. Similarly, I am taking triangle PII dash. Triangle PII dash. So, what about tan theta? That equal to II dash by PI. II dash by PI. This is my second equation. LHS equal. So, automatically RHS also equal. So, what happens here? OO dash by PO. That equal to II dash by PI. This is my equation number 3. In this candida, this by this. In this candida, this by this. Again, comparing this, we are getting equation number 3. Now, what is the II dash height of the image? So, that thing I am taking. It implies this PI coming this side. So PI by PO that equal to II dash by OO dash. Height of the image by height of the object. That only called magnification. So this is the magnification for particular case. But I want to apply for any case, for any mirror, any lens, any position. For that purpose, applying sign convention. By applying sign convention, by applying sign convention, we are getting generalized equation. We are getting generalized equation. Okay, what are the sign conventions? Beam of light coming from this direction, from the optic center, in this direction, any measurement value, reverse negative, that you apply. Okay, tell me what is the PI? PI is the image distance, positive only. So, plus V. What is the PO? Object distance, minus U. What is the II dash? Height of the image, I had already told you, rule 2. Above the principal axis, positive height. Below the principal axis, negative height. So, what is this? minus height of the image. Height of the object is above the menstrual height, so positive. Height of the object. So this minus minus cancel. Height of the image by height of the object equal to V by U. This height of the image by height of the object only forward magnification. So therefore, magnification M equals to height of the image by height of the object. That equals to V by U. So this is the generalized equation for any lens. It may be concave lens or may be convex lens or any position. In this again you apply sign convention to go to your particular condition. Because from the particular condition by applying sign convention we have got the generalized equation. In this generalized equation again by applying sign convention we are going to particular case. It may be concave lens or may be convex lens. May be magnified image or diminished image or virtual image. So for various cases again you apply sign convention. So that is the process.